The HEROES Act provides economic stability.
Stop, Tim. This is a congressperson from New Mexico, Deb Haaland. I tried to do a little research on her. There is scant information about this person. And she's going on national television. She's acting like she knows what she's talking about. I have no idea what her resume is like. I have no idea whether she's owned and operated a business or what she did really prior to being elected to Congress. Yet here she is telling us the, quote, HEROES Act. And I love the names they gave to these pieces of legislation. The HEROES Act. She's telling us that the HEROES Act is going to somehow rejuvenate the United States economy. We know what is in the, quote, HEROES Act. It has nothing to do with heroes, unless, of course, you consider Andrew Cuomo a hero, unless, of course, you consider Gavin Newsom a hero, or Pritzker in Illinois a hero. It contains money for the states and local governments, by the way. The hero in Los Angeles, for example, Eric Garcetti, who's bankrupting his city and doing so with glee and a little smirk on his face. There is money contained within the HEROES Act to bail out the states. And it's not because of the Wuhan coronavirus. New York had a deficit going into this debacle. So Andrew Cuomo just doubles down, increases the deficit even more, and says, hey, federal government, not only do you need to give us ventilators, which Cuomo should have had in his hospitals, not only should I have more hospital beds, which Cuomo should have accounted for in his state, but now he wants the federal government. He wants you and me to pay his bills. This is what's going on here right now. And the same thing in California. Gavin Newsom, going into this thing, said fallaciously that there was a surplus in California, and it's all wiped out now, ostensibly because of the Wuhan coronavirus. This is nonsense. California is in huge financial trouble. He's just not counting the CalPERS, which is the retirement fund for state workers. CalPERS is effectively bankrupt, and he needs the money to keep his state running. He knows it. And the same with little Eric Garcetti in Los Angeles. His city is in financial peril right now, yet he keeps strangling businesses. Each day he comes out and says, you have to do something else, keeps moving the goalposts for the people of Los Angeles to not only get back to their lives and maybe possibly someday go back to school and back to jobs, but opening up business. He keeps changing the rules. And so they're destroying their own economies, but they went into this thing with huge budget deficits, and now they want you and me to bail them out. That's what's contained in here, along with a whole bunch of other nefarious stuff, which, by the way, includes a bailout for the post office. Do you see? The Democrats never give up on the post office, do they? They don't want to pay any attention to Federal Express and any of the other companies that move our mail effectively as a private entity. They want to keep bailing out the Postal Service, which, by the way, also has a pension system that's blowing a hole through itself. And that's one of the reasons why the Postal Service is insolvent, because of the wonderful and generous benefits bestowed upon its retirees. That has to stop. Instead, we have the Democrats bailing out the states, bailing out the cities, or the blue states and blue cities, and now trying to bail out the post office once again. Isn't that a wonderful thing? This is the HEROES Act. Roll tape.
Begin the long road to economic recovery. $1,200.
It's interesting that she would use those choices of words, right? The long road to recovery. Is that really what we're looking at here? If the blue state governors suddenly waved a magic wand like they should be doing and said, hey, reopen, this entire thing is a farce. And by the way, red state governors ought to be doing it too. They would just take a lot of flack from the mainstream media if they did. But if they just waved a magic wand and said, hey, the economy's reopened, would it really be a long road to recovery? So why is she using those words, a long road to recovery? Could it be that this is maybe exposing a little bit of the nefarious plot that this entire episode is all about, and that is to strangle the economy going into the November election so it harms President Trump? She showed a little ankle there, didn't she? So this profligate spending by Congress is increasingly reckless. It's just amazing to me that the majority of the American people are okay with spending trillions and trillions of dollars that we do not have. This republic has got to get a handle on the debt and deficit spending. Congress is not going to do it. In the end, one way or another, just like protecting our liberty, fixing this fiscal mess is going to be up to we the people.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.